I am this community, Clovia, and it's a misunderstood history as we're expanding the narrative. And we are highlighting some super soul sisters. And Elvatrice Belschese is my author, lecturer. She does deep research. And now we're going to talk about Virginia Randolph.
Right. Miss Virginia Estelle Randolph was an incredible educator and humanitarian. She was born shortly after the Civil War, right here in the city of Richmond. She also was educated at Richmond Colored Normal, which would later become Armstrong. But she made history when she came to the old Mountain Road School in Henrico County in the 1890s. She was an expert at integrating reading, writing, and arithmetic with the trades. And so she realized you had to train the heart, the head, the hands, and you know, the brain, everything. And so, but her methods were so extraordinary that it would culminate in creating what's called the Henrico method. And people realized that what she was doing was unusual and incredible. So when about $1 million was left to rural black schools in the South by Miss Jeans, she was tapped to be the first Jeans teacher, supervising industrial teacher. And she, her method was used not only throughout the state of Virginia, but throughout rural black schools in the South, even British colonies in Africa, and some places in Southeast Asia. So she was extraordinary. She would travel around. She was really living in the Carver neighborhood. She would oftentimes cook breakfast, dismantle that hot stove, and take it to her school to show women how to teach. To show women how to cook, if you will. She boarded, it is stated, was of 100 kids in her home over the decades, course of decades. She gave everything she had to education. And so she is really, a monument to what it means to just give all of yourself, if you will.
And you're talking about it. It's like I almost can feel the importance of education. And this book, Black America Series, Richmond, Virginia, your book, authored by you, everything you need to know about us is inside this book. And it should be a part of curriculums, not only in the Richmond public school systems, but all around the nation in our elementary, middle, and high schools. Don't you agree? Not only because you're the author of the book, but it's an easy read, Elva.
When I created it, actually in 2001, I wanted something that could be utilized by third graders through visiting scholars alike. And I'm blessed to say it's been successful in that regard. It is used when historical sites come up for the Landmarks Registry. They cite the book. It's being cited by doctoral students in their dissertations. It's carried in over 40 libraries across America, and some people around the world actually have it. So it's a blessing because it has lived up to what I prayed for. Mm-hmm. You know, something that can be utilized by children and visiting scholars alike all the way through.
We're a product of Richmond Public Schools.
Yes, and also historically black college and university. Yes. Hampton University, absolutely.
VUU, Virginia Union University. Education is the key to opening doors, not only here, but around the world.
Yes.
And that's what we want for our black sisters, too. Not to take away from any other race and the wonderful things that they're doing to educate their families, but our black sisters, too. So you're that black sister, Elvatrice Parker Belschese. She's the author of Black America Series, Richmond, Virginia. It's a misunderstood history, another education class. I am this community club.